Yes. Will it,
perhaps
will it,
we should ask.
Will it allow special circumstances to have the prosecution offer additional evidence? So you're right, Adele. Maybe your guest can answer that better.
I think he would be in a better position to answer that.
Let's welcome to our discussion Senator Cheese Escudero. Senator, magandang hapon.
Linda, Adele, Tony, Karen, sa ating televiewers, magandang hapon.
Ayun. So dun tayo nagtapos ano, dun sa point na medyo na-titillate yung prosecution kahapon nung sinabi ni Senate President Enrile na hindi ba kayo tumingin sa Batangas? Yun ang home province ng Chief Justice eh. Baka may nakita kayo, makita kayo doon.
Well, ang mas maganda sana yung dagdag pa nga kahapon. Pero bugbog sarado na si LRA Administrator Diaz. Kung sumulat pa lang si sila Congressman Tupas ng January 7 at sumagot siya ng January 10 at doon pa lang nila nalaman, ibig sabihin nung final nila impeachment complaint, eh hindi nila alam na may mga ganun palang ari-arian. In fact, niwala pa rin silang kopya nung salin. So all of these accusations were made. Kumbaga, nauna yung kagustuhang sampahan siya ng impeachment bago yung ebidensya laban sa kanya kaugnay ng impeachment.
Kasi nga sui generis, kaya pwedeng mauna yung... No, on the point of, for example, obviously they're gonna ask LRA to present, to make a search, no? Or let's assume they will ask LRA to make a search. Pag may na-discover silang ibang properties, pwede pa ba nilang i-present yun sa rebuttal?
Sa akin, wala na. At pinag-usapan na rin yan nila Senate President Enrile at Congressman Tupas Kapon, di ba? Na nagulat daw si Congressman Tupas na Metro Manila lang pala yung search. Pero inamin din ni Congressman Tupas kahapon sa pagtatanong ni Senate President Enrile na nag-rest na sila. Tapos na yun. At tama si Adele. They can no longer present additional evidence insofar as their original complaint is concerned. And more so, new matters not even touched upon by the defense in their presentation of evidence.
So, bakit sa tingin mo? Kasi maraming nagtataka eh, lalo na sa social media. Ano ba yung tono ng pananalita ni Senate President Enrile? Bakit parang sinasuggest niya pa daw doon sa...
Hindi, I think papunta lamang yun doon sa... Pati ako nagulat eh, Metro Manila search lang pala yun. Bakit nga naman hindi lahat ng syudad o munisipyo sa Metro Manila? I think just goes into the... thoroughness by which the LRA did its job when it came up with the list.
But of course, they only had January 8th... Prosecutor Tupas called up LRA in January 16 na yung hearing ay in trial eh. So
but it begs the question, Linda. Adele would know that before you go on trial, especially if you're the one filing a case. Kaya nga mahaba yung proseso ng finding of probable cause, may preliminary investigation, dahil ideally in a perfect world bago ka magsampa ng kaso eh handa na lahat yun at alam mo na eksakto kung paano may ipipresenta yung ebidensya at ano ipipresenta mo laban sa isang akusado.
Senator Cheese, let me go to somewhat legal point. No?
Yes.
The defense will be presenting a lot of witnesses, essentially talking about where certain funds were obtained. And my thinking in regard to this, it seems to, they want to prove that these are not illegally obtained funds. And in a way, they were going to prove that this is the source of the funds. But as I asked Congressman Kimbo and Attorney Kicho, isn't it what the senators are really looking for? It's just an explanation as to why these funds were not included in the SALN, and perhaps the provenance of these funds is something that is really not essential to the articles of impeachment per se.
Well, two things, Adele. Remember, when we disallowed presentation of evidence on ill-gotten wealth, the main reason cited by the presiding officer in the Senate, in effect, was that you did not allege it properly, but if you are able to prove that he has wealth above that of his salary, then it is presumed under the law to be ill-gotten. And the burden shifts on the defense to prove that it is not. I think that's what the defense is trying to do now. They're trying to prove that it's not ill-gotten. Although the prosecution did not present evidence on it, the law provides for the presumption that if you have assets in your name outside your capacity to earn, it's presumed to be ill-gotten. And therefore, the burden is on the defense to prove that it's not. I think that's what they're trying to do, one. And two, I think, or although I would not want to preempt the defense, I think what they will prove is it is not ill-gotten and not mine. I'm holding it in trust or something. It's not mine. I think they're heading towards or leading towards that. Kasi mahirap ipaliwanag, hindi na nga sa'yo, eh, hindi mo mapaliwanag kung saan galing. So they have to explain where it came from, perhaps to lay the basis in showing or proving or convincing the court that it's not his.
LJ, just as a final question to Senator Cheese, this is a pet peeve of mine, forgive me. No, I keep asking the other senators about it. maybe wouldn't be one of the lessons learned so far is the need for a pretrial? Because for example, you have been very consistent in regard, mag-agree na kayo kung anong properties are included at hindi. And that would have been proper subject matter of a pretrial. Looking forward, do you think this will be something that you will incorporate in the rules?
Definitely, perhaps? Definitely, Adele. Learning from our lessons in this impeachment trial, hopefully kumatapos to, and some other improvements in our rules. For example, I myself would want to allow the lawyers to object to questions propounded by a senator because it's quite unfair on both sides. If the parties cannot protect their clients' rights whenever a senator judge is asking
you raised that at one of the early stages, at the beginning.
And secondly, on pre-trial, although the Constitution says shall forthwith proceed with trial, it's a matter of defining pre-trial as part of trial used generically in the Constitution.
Okay. Well, let me turn you over to Karen and Tony in the studio.
Si Senator Chis, number two sa
House Asian Wall.
Parang Tony, ang sweldo ng 1 at 13 kasi 13 yata ang i-elect sa 2013.
Pareho lang.
Ang term nga lang ng number 13, 3 years lang dahil it will only finish the term of Senator Santiago after she assumes office.
There will be 13.
Hindi pwede palitan.
Interesting, right?
So pag umupo na sa
ICC, International Criminal Court.
Si Senator Miriam, mababakante yung pwesto niya. So, yung pwesto niya, ikalibang tatlo na pupunuin.
Apa, her term, she was just elected last 2010 and her term is supposed to end in 2016. So, yung pang 13 will serve 3 years, but that will still be his or her first term or second term for that matter dun sa anim na re-electionista.
Okay.
That's
what happened to Senator Gringo Onasan before, ano, na he only served the unexpired term of Senator Manglapus or
Because he was appointed Foreign Affairs Secretary.
Right.
The first time we elected senators in 1987. Kung maalala nyo, bata pa ako nang kaka-graduate ko high school noon. The top 12 served for 6 years and the lower 12 served for 3 years para masimula na yung unang cycle ng 12-12 na lamang every 3 years.
Right, okay.
Senator Cheese, I wanted to ask, balikan natin yung kaso. What are your thoughts when it comes to the contested properties? I want to know how your, deciding on this particular matter. The prosecution says, hindi porket wala sa pangalan ni Chief Justice tulad ng Marikina lots, hindi ibig sabihin, hindi kanya yon, kanya pa rin daw yon. Yung titulo naman sa McKinley Hill, nasa pangalan ng anak niya, pero kanya pa rin yun. So I want to know what you are thinking as a senator judge, because I think there are only 6 contested properties left that include some parking areas.
Personally, Karen, para sa akin, from 45, 21 na lang talaga ang pinag-aawayan dito. Ang claim ni Chief Justice ay 5 plus 1 o 6 dahil yung Saviorville property, dalawang titulo yun. Pero dineklara naman niya yung Saviorville property niya.
Okay.
So you're talking of approximately 15. Of the 15, tatlo doon ay parking lot.
Okay.
Sa totoo lang, ayoko nang isama sa debate at awa yung parking lot.
Okay. Same as Senator Coco Pimentel.
So you're talking of 12 properties. 7 dito ay yung Marikina properties. So essentially, ang pinag-aawayan na lamang talaga ay yung 5 na nakapangalan sa iba't ibang tao, kamag-anak ni Chief Justice sa Corona. At yung hindi pa naman nalilipat o hindi pa nila tinatanggap. It's a matter of evidence and proof already, Karen, to my mind. But I think it begs the question still. The main question that we should confront is, ano ba yung limitasyon ng hindi pagdeklara na pwede mo i-considerang impeachable na?
Okay.
Halimbawa, sa tax, pag pinag-usapan natin, pag nag-misdeclare ka ng more than 30%, doon palang magiging evasion yon. Sa Amerika, sa kanilang similar na batas sa SALN, it's a range, plus or minus 30%. So pag lumabas ka sa 30% na yon, dun pa lamang magiging violation ng batas. Dito wala tayong ganung standard at hindi ko alam kung anong i-apply ng mga kasamahan kong senator judges, but personally I am veering towards that. It must be a range. It cannot be exact.
Okay.
Kasi malay mo, nadagdagan ng piso yung pera mo at nalagay mo, hindi accurate by 1 peso, 10 pesos ba, 1,000? 100,000 ba yung difference of variance? 1 million ba bago maging violation? I'm looking at the 30% range within which a public official can and should declare his true net worth.
Senator Ralph Recto, Senator Trillanes, and yourself, kumbaga, you are all agreeing that a 30% discrepancy is all right?
Hindi naman all right, Karen, pero... kasi saan mo ibabata yung diferensya? Paano pag biglang nag-increase yung fair market value, hindi mo naman alam dahil you're not in the market, hindi mo binibenta yung ari-arian mo.
Mm-mm.
How would you know the exact fair market value if you won't base it or if you cannot base it dun sa ordinansyang nagde-declare ng fair market schedules? Yung pera mo sa banko, paano pag biglang may pumasok, biglang may lumabas, biglang nadagdagan? Again, it's a difficult situation. In fact, I'm all in favor sana of calling the PCIJ. If the Senate will not subpoena them, I hope they will accede to the invitation of the defense. Because that will show us, Karen and Tony, best practices.
Okay.
Kasi wala naman tayong maliwanag na expert on SALN eh.
Mm.
But at least that will show best practices of other officials on how it's been done.
Mm-mm.
And I hope that it will be able to guide us in coming up with a standard. Because right now, there is no standard.
Mm-mm.
And the worst thing we can do is to have a double standard. Applying a different rule to a different set of officials and a different rule for different sets of officials.
Okay, now that you've mentioned not wanting to have a double standard, Tony and I were discussing this a few days ago. Paano po, sir, yung dalawang court employees, I believe, who were removed from their posts? By the Supreme Court. One did not declare a market stall. Yung isa did not declare owning two luxury vehicles. Would that have a different standard to, let's say, the Chief Justice not putting in certain data in his SALN?
I have to be frank, Karen, I haven't read those two cases. I've heard it mentioned, but I've heard two different interpretations with respect to those cases, that there were other matters.
Okay.
Sabi ng panig ng depensa, there were other matters and considerations in the dismissal of that employee, and not only the SALN. Sabi naman ng prosecution, yun lang daw ang basihan. Actually, bala kong basahin yan habang recess at break namin. I haven't had the chance to read on the specifics of those two cases. I cannot rely on the word of the defense and the prosecution because, of course, they're advocating for their particular side. But let me take this opportunity to remind them, and Adele knows this. Under our ethics and our rules and principles of being a lawyer, Karen, Tony, the job of the prosecution is not to convict. And the job of the defense counsels is not only to acquit. Their job and duty to the court is to see to it that justice is done. Kaya minsan nakakainis panoorin one side putting one over the other. Nilalamangan nung isa yung isa, itatago nila yung certain facts using the same witness, but they forget that they owe fealty and loyalty to the court and to the justice system and to the delivery of justice, not to their client's cause, not to their particular side. Because as I said, if I may repeat, their job is not to prosecute nor to convict nor to acquit, but to see to it that justice is done.
All right, Tony?
Well, siguro ilalabas din na ebidensya ng defense, you know, in regards to Article 3 and Article 7. Meron po ba sa tingin ninyo, Senator, na mabigat na kailangang i-rebut ng defense do sa sinabi na o inilabas na ng prosecution?
Prudence is always the better part of valor, Tony. Kung ako sa kanila, when in doubt, magpresenta sila ng rebuttal evidence kesa tayuan nila yung sa paniniwala nilang nagawa nila. Sa kaso sa korte o sa election man, mahirap maging overconfident.
Mm.
So kung may ebidensya ka pang pwedeng ilabas, kung sa tingin mo, kailangan pa talaga yan, huwag kang magdalawang isip at ilahad mo. Kesa naman dumating sa punto na matatalo ka sa dulo, marami ka pa naman sanang pwedeng gawin o ebidensya ang pwedeng ipresenta na nalalaman mo. Pero either tinamad ka lang o na mali yung estima mo kaugnay sa dami ng ebidensya na ipresenta mo na para kumbinsihin yung senator judges. Again, it's better safe than sorry. I think that's a safer rule to follow.
Oo, kasi parang sa mata ng maraming tao din, mas maraming na ipresenta yung prosecution sa Article 2, obviously. Mm-hmm. Ano? Pero pagdating sa Article 3 and 7, halos masasabi mong kakaramput lang.
Totoo.
Na hindi tila naging ganun kabigat yung presentasyon ng prosecution.
Actually, hindi ko nag...
Yes, Senator.
Kundi ako nagkakamali, Tony, isa lang ang test ang tumestigo kaugnay sa 7.
And 3.
At kaugnay sa 3, isa lang o dalawa?
Fasap.
Fasap lamang at saka si Secretary De Lima.
Ay, correct. Oo.
No, Secretary De Lima is in pero, 7.
Secretary, seven. Dalawa lang yun, di ba? On the two, one each.
So one each, oo.
So one each lamang. Nagulat nga kami na biglang nag-rest na lamang ang prosecution dun sa balanse ng lima. But it's only one each. And you have a Supreme Court decision that allegedly came out on the FASAP case. I have yet to read that Supreme Court decision too. Mm. If indeed it affects the standing or the accusations hurled against the Chief Justice. But I guess kaya hinuhuli ng prosecution yon. Sa pananaw at palagay nila, mas madaling patunayan yung kabaliktaran ng pinatunayan ng prosecution sa panig and party at party nila. I think they're taking their sweet time with respect to Article 2 because this is really the crux of the matter. This is where I think the prosecution scored some points when they were presenting evidence and not so much on the two other articles, much less the five articles that they dropped.
Oo, kasi ang parang ang kutob ko lang eh hindi na kailangan magpresenta pa yung depensa sa Article 3 and 7 dahil wala naman silang halos kailangan i-rebut doon. Yung sinabi ni Secretary De Lima, accepted on the record, pero dahil hearsay naman supposed to be yung sinabi niya, the senator judges are also reminded by the presiding officer na as to the veracity or truthfulness or accuracy of what she said, hindi pwede i-consider dahil hindi siya party to the decision of the Supreme Court.
Tama po yan, Tony, but following the same rule I cited a while ago, better safe than sorry. Prudence. I think the defense will still present evidence on those two articles just to be safe, just to be on the safe side, just so that they can rebut, contradict, or create some doubt with respect to the points that the prosecution tried to prove on Article
7. Si Maidas Marquez daw ang iuupo nilang witness sa Article 7.
Tinatawag din.
Interesting yan, Tony. Para tumastas naman uli yung rating ng impeachment.
Ay, ganon.
Si Chief Justice, si...
Okay, sige.
Para tumastas naman, para pag-opening natin sa Day 35.
Day 35, May 7.
Linda, season 3 na yun, di ba?
Yes, season 3.
Season 3, parang BBB to.
Dapat,
Day 35, season 3, hindi. Medyo may konting excitement na naghihintay.
Hindi ito PBB, Senator Cheese. Ito yung Game of Crowns, hindi Game of Thrones.
Okay.
Tinitingnan natin kung yung yung corona ay matatanggal sa ulo ng punong maestrado. Yun ang trailer ng season 3. Senator Cheese Escudero, thank you very much for being there with our resident legal analyst, Attorney Adel Tamano and Linda Humilla.
Thank you, Tony. Thank you, Karen, Linda, and Adel. Thank you. And to our televiewers, magandang hapon.
Thank you.
All right. Live pictures coming in from the gallery at the Senate Session Hall. Former Budget Secretary under the Estrada administration and UP Professor Benjamin Jokno talking there to former, I think that's Sulu, former Sulu Governor Al Tila there at the Senate gallery. So just a little under 2 p.m. When we expect the session